India Beyond the Boardroom. It gives me great pleasure to say that we have reached our second season of our show. This is a show where we have guests from all kind of fields, from films to sports to businesses. But we don't talk about their profession, we talk about everything beyond that. Today's guest graduated from IIT Roorkee in 2013 and started working as a field engineer at Schumacher. But then he left that lucrative job in 2014 to team up with his college buddy to start a fintech startup that simplifies online payments. It achieved unicorn status in October last year. He has also been featured under Forbes India 30 Under 30 in 2017. We have with us today Harshal Mathur, CEO and co-founder of Razorpay. Harshal, welcome to Forbes India Beyond the Board.
Hey, thanks, June. Thanks for inviting. Really glad to be here.
You have a black belt in karate and you are a national level silver medalist. Tell us all about it. What made you take up karate as a kid?
My dad was an inspiration. My dad used to be a karate coach. So I grew up watching him practice karate and then become a referee. And I think very early, I think in first standard or so, I started practicing karate. And it grew up as a passion for me because I really enjoyed the thrill that karate gave. So I really used to enjoy that. And I think it kind of shaped up a lot of my personality as well.
Apparently, your mother called it a violent sport and didn't quite like you doing it.
Yeah, my mother was like any Indian mother, right? She didn't want me to come to any harm because of anything that I would do, right? And karate demonstrations usually involved, right? Me, for example, breaking a stack of bricks, right? I remember one of the Republic Day demonstrations where my dad drove a bike on my stomach, right?
Oh,
and
my
when we used to train for tightening our stomachs for something like this, right? Like for a bike going over it. There'd be like 50 small students, young students learning in the class. So he would ask all of them to come and punch me in the stomach.
Oh God.
And each of those young guys would try their best to put all their force in and try to punch me. But those are the ways that you have to train, right? Like otherwise, how would your stomach reach that hardness that you can really literally drive a bike over it?
Of course. Harshal, tell us about this incident. I think it was in 2006 when you were competing in nationals and you got injured. Tell us about this story and also what was your takeaway from this? Was there a lesson involved?
In one of the fights, the opponent like punched me a little aggressively and I got hit in the stomach pretty bad. I almost collapsed and I couldn't continue the fight, right? Like the doctor came and said, like, you can't continue right now. You have been hurt pretty badly. So I got disqualified. So I went back to training after a couple of months after that incident and then started training again. 2008, I qualified for nationals again, went and fought and got a silver medal. So I think the only lesson was that like that perseverance is important, right? Like you can't give up.
Tell us about your IIT days. Do you have any fun stories to share from the IIT hostels and the classrooms?
College is of course one of the most fun times of my life, right? And I think it was the first time I stepped out of my home, stayed in a hostel. I think in the early days, I was very scared of staying in a hostel. I had never stepped out of my home. First year, I remember watching so many movies with my friends, right? Like 10, 12 of us. Like we didn't, all of us didn't used to have a laptop. So one person would have a laptop. So 10, 12 of us would cramp into one small dorm room and watch a movie together, right? And we would binge 3 movies in a night, 4 movies in a night. I met Shashank, my co-founder, in the second year of college. And we got together to become part of this group that we started called the Software Development Section. And that is the first time I started working together with Shashank and into building projects. So what we did was we bought one dish, Tata Sky dish, and used our laptop. I built an application to stream the TV channels, especially a cricket match, live to everyone's hostel. And people really loved that. I think that was my first time when I built something, deployed it, and I started getting users of sort, right? Like they were like, at one point, there were like 4,000 or 5,000 students from IIT watching it.
Harshal, I think you call yourself an ambivert, which is basically someone who's a mix of both an extrovert and an introvert. What exactly is your personality like?
Yeah, I think there is a side of your personality which is natural and then the side of personality that you have to build, right? Because it's part of the job, right? So my natural personality is ambivert, right? Like if I was in a room where I don't know anyone, I'll try to find somebody that I know and might spend the entire evening with them, right? Like, but once I know a group of friends that I really, really know well, within them, I am very extrovert, right? Like I would lead all conversations. I would decide where do we go, what do we do today, and things like that. So within the group of people that I know, I'm very extroverted, but by default, I'm introverted when I'm faced with a new set of people. But yeah. As a part of running a company, of course, I have to sometimes change my personality. Sometimes, like for example, in the early days, I remember I would go to startup events and I would force myself to go and meet everyone and introduce myself. It was very uncomfortable for me because naturally that's not my personality. But I had to do what I had to do for the company.
What's your all-time favorite cuisine? I think you grew up in Jaipur. So are you a fan of this Rajasthani cuisine?
Actually, love Rajasthani cuisine. I think my go-to food is Rajasthani food. Dal bati is my standard go-to food. Whenever I'm, if I feel sad at the end of a day or if I had too much pressure at the end of a day, I want to have dal bati churma.
You apparently also love go-karting.
Yeah. In fact, like one of my favorite sports these days is go-karting. It's a sport that looks from outside, it looks like it's all about speed and going fast. But when you step into it, it turns out it's a lot about control, right? It's not about who goes the fastest, but who is able to navigate the turns the best. So I love the thrill and the self-control that it brings in.
Like your Bollywood buff who watches a lot of movies and all?
Movies that I grew up in, like in the generation, like in the 90s and early 2000s. I love a lot of movies in that time. And in fact, even sometimes I would just take a movie out that I watched and just watch it again. I think I love a lot of movies of that generation, probably because we grew up with them. Chak De is a sports movie. I think it's one movie that I can always watch. In fact, even today, if it comes out on TV, I would watch it again. Nayak. Anil Kapoor's Nayak is an amazing movie. I would watch it anytime it comes out on TV. I would watch it. Three Idiots is of course one. So a lot of movies that I can name there. If I talk about comedy, I think Ishq is a movie that I watch.
If you have to like probably list out three books for our viewers that are must read according to you, what would they be?
The first book I would say is Hard Things About Hard Things. It's a book that every entrepreneur should definitely read. It talks a lot about how you should think about building a company and scaling culture and a lot of those things. I think the second book I would recommend is the Jobs biography. It's pretty amazing. And I think Steve Jobs is one of the best visionaries to read about. The last book I would recommend is Founders at Work by Jessica Livingston. It's not so much a book, it's a combination of interviews that Jessica did with multiple founders, all the top guys. And I think it lists down how they went through their journey and what were they thinking when they started their companies.
What kind of shows do you binge watch on?
Some of the shows that I loved is Suits, for example, the legal drama. It's really amazing. Prison Break. I think Friends, of course, is an evergreen show that everyone must have seen.
Lastly, Harshal, before we end, would you have any kind of advice for all those young entrepreneurs out there?
Yeah, a couple of advices. First is I think if you are building, don't build a startup to build a startup. I think what worked for us is that we wanted to solve a problem that we faced ourselves. And I think and that shaped up into a startup over time, right? The second and most important advice is perseverance. Even if you start with something and you go in something and something unlucky happens, some incident happens and you're not able to scale up, it happens very frequently to almost every entrepreneur because entrepreneurship is full of failures, right? So I believe it a lot, which is what YC says, make something people want, right? So if you know enough people who want a certain thing and you start building towards that, you can never go wrong.
Absolutely. Thank you, Harshal, so much for joining us on Forbes India Beyond the Boardroom. Thank you.
Thank you, John.